So you put this together all yourself. What's your name?
Jolena Freeman.
Jolena, take me step by step. What were you trying to get across here?
So this is basically to represent the people that have died in the water crisis, and also people, you know, who are going to be probably continuing to die because of the effects of the chemicals and the lead and things like that in the water, Legionnaires, the bacteria. And so each one of these stars represents a year that we've been going through this. We got 5 years, this is the fifth year. And right here, you know, our water was compared to toxic sludge, and this here, it represents the sludge and, you know, our water being sludge. This here is the bacteria, you know. It's kind of kid-friendly because we need people to just kind of understand our water crisis from, you know, everybody needs to understand the water crisis. Like, we just had one of our littlest fighters up there speaking. Even he knows about the water crisis and that we shouldn't be drinking the water. And so I think it's important that we explain it to the rest of the world and, you know, in a way that people can understand it at any level, you know, because it's a very complex thing.
Well, you know what really is strange to me? You have Governor Snyder declared the water, his words, were restored a year ago, and you have people still getting rashes, people are still losing hair. Spoke with someone last night, eyes sting in the shower. A lot of people put out, you know, on social media, discolored water, smells. So how are they saying the water's fine when you're living it and it's not?
Like Snyder said, they want to just get over it. They want to move Flint forward. And we can't move forward because we're still in a crisis. I mean, we have people getting their water shut off, a mass amount of people getting water shut offs. And, you know, we have a lot of people who weren't paying their water bills in protest because we all felt we shouldn't be paying for poison. And on top of that, we're paying the highest water rates in the nation. And so
I want to stop you right there. Let that sink in. They're paying the highest water rates in the country for water they cannot consume safely.
Right. On top of having to buy bottled water because they're not giving water out, which is not a free handout, because you don't mess up our whole entire city and poison our whole city and our pipes and mess up our pipes and then expect us to fix it. So we're not asking for free handouts. We are asking to be made whole. Flint needs to be made whole. And speaking about the people who have effects, who get affected by the water, I mean, everybody has to shower, right? We shower, you know, usually every day, and we try to. And my daughter, she showers every day, and she happens to be someone who has asthma. Now, I don't know if a lot of people realize asthma causes your body to have a low immune system, right? So she's had tests done, and all her little things come back low. So she's low on in having an immune system that can support her and keep her healthy all the time. Well, when she goes and takes a shower, every day I have to give her a Benadryl because her whole body breaks out in an allergic reaction. And I have to say, you know, I took her to the allergist because of all the welts that she gets after the shower, and he tried to say that the reaction was because she was allergic to hot water, and the doctors here are laughing at us. They're laughing at our problems, and they're not really taking us seriously because they don't want to get involved. A lot of people just do not want to get involved because, you know, as you see it, you could end up getting in trouble if you admit too much that you know too much and you haven't said anything. So people aren't trying to really say anything.
Well, I also think part of it that never gets discussed: a lot of these hospitals, a lot of these foundations, a lot of these groups get funding from outfits like the Mott Foundation that very much want the water crisis to be over because it's actually interfering with possible plans for gentrification. What are your thoughts on that?
Well,
because they were talking about capitalism and a lot of people on Wall Street trying to take advantage.
Well, we are getting taken advantage of. We're going to take advantage of left and right from anybody. People come in from out of town. They set up little 501(c)s and collect money on the backs of the residents. And where is the help? the help for the actual residents. We can't even get help with our water bills. There's no help with water bills, but we're constantly getting shut off. So, you know, I just don't think that they have the Flint residents in their forefront, and, you know, they're just leaving us here to die, basically, you know, and letting gentrification take over, absolutely.
Last question. What's your message to other people? Because I think other people need to realize that it might be Flint, but there's water problems in Detroit, Milwaukee, Cleveland, Pittsburgh, Philadelphia, Florida, Massachusetts, Long Island. I mean, I could go on and on and on. There's lead problems. There's new chemical. There's PFAAs, which are cancer-causing chemicals, arsenic, uranium mines. There is water contamination pretty much all over this country.
Right. And to not to try to minimize their problems, but kind of when we talk about, when we're talking about Flint, we just want to kind of talk about Flint, because what happened in Flint, it was done deliberately. We were poisoned by policy. It was a man-made disaster here. This wasn't just a natural disaster that just so happened to happen. No, people did not do their jobs, and people in Flint were poisoned because of it. And we're still being poisoned every day because we still are getting our pipes replaced. We still can't drink the water. My daughter is still breaking out every day with every shower. I mean, that is ridiculous. It's horrible to have to live through. It's horrible to have to live through. I have now got high blood pressure. I'm only 40 years old. I've never had an issue. And just 2 weeks ago, I was hospitalized because I had high blood pressure out of nowhere. You know, and I don't drink the water. You know, I've been drinking bottled water. But before that, you know, I was drinking the water. And I do still shower in this water every day. We have to. We have no choice. We're not getting this bottled water into Flint to even when we did, to shower and bathe in bottled water really isn't feasible for everyone. I mean, we try to let have the babies and the people who really, 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 really need to, you know, probably do that. But I can't, my daughter, she's grown, she's taller than me. I cannot bathe her in bottled water, you know what I'm saying, every day. That's just, you know what I'm saying? This is what we're going through every day. This is what we're expected to do. And people just say, get over it. It's been 5 years. Well, you know what? We're tired, too. We're tired, too. And we just want our stuff fixed. We want to be able to have our water running without having to worry about being poisoned on a daily basis, you know, because it's like Russian roulette. You never know if you're going to get Legionnaires when you touch that water, take a shower. You just don't know. And, you know, we just want people to know not to drink that water. That water is still not safe to drink. It's not safe to bathe in. It's not safe to brush your teeth in, to cook with. Nothing. You don't
you're
even
still And you're, you're still getting rashes.
I'm still getting rashes. My face breaks out. My skin breaks out. I still, you know, I'm getting this high blood pressure out of nowhere. My hair, I've lost a ton of hair. I don't know if you could tell, but I have lost pounds and pounds of hair.
Still.
I mean, this is happening today. It's not over. It has never been over. Whoever said it's over is a lie. It is a flat-out lie. Still continuing. 5 years and counting.
Hope you enjoyed that last video. Hop on over to statuscoup.com where you can sign up for our email list and become a member for as low as $5 to $10 a month. Membership is how we grow. That's statuscoup.com/join. And remember, join our email list so we can grow the revolution with you.